Good evening, one and all. My topic today is semiology of seizures and management of status epilepticus in children. So, first few thoughts about the semiology. What do you mean by semiology? Semiology is the exact clinical presentation of seizures. Why we are interested in knowing the semiology of seizures? For example, few type of seizures aggravated by some anti-epileptic drugs. Example, if we are using carbamazepine or phenytoin or phenobarbital in myoclonic seizures or absent seizures, the seizure frequency gets increased or the seizure gets worsened. So before treating the seizures, we have to know the exactly what is the type of seizures. Then only we have to select the anticonvulsant accordingly. So this is the brief overview about my talk. First, a brief introduction. Then definition. What is seizures? What is epilepsy? What is convulsion? Actually, in our practice, we are using these terminologies interchangeably, but it's not true exactly. Each has its own definition. Then types of seizures. Few types of seizures with videos. Then few words about the pseudo seizures, status epilepticus, refractory status epilepticus, and non-convulsive status epilepticus. So seizures is a common neurological disease with an incidence of 10% in the community, and it has got a bimodal age distribution. It's highest in first year and after 60 years. In the first year, febrile seizures and the infective causes are very common. After 60 years, metabolic and the structural causes are very common. And status epilepticus is a neurological emergency. When we are not treating in time, the status epilepticus, the mortality is very high. So, everybody in this hall accept this statement. Few things are more frightening to parents than to witness their child having a seizure. So, these are the definition. What is epilepsy? Epilepsy is a brain disorder characterized by an enduring predisposition to generate epileptic seizures and by the neurobiologic, cognitive, psychological, and social consequences of this condition. Seizures is the manifestation of abnormal hypersynchronous discharges of cortical neurons, and convulsion is a seizure with prominent motor manifestation. So, few words about the generalized tonic-clonic seizures. It is the commonest type of seizure, and it begins suddenly without any warning. It has got totally 5 stages. First is premonitory stage, then pre-tonic-clonic, tonic-clonic, then postictal phases. It has got rhythmic clonic contraction alternating with relaxation of all muscle groups, and the patient may got urine or fecal incontinence. Seizure duration usually lasts 1 to 2 minutes and with a postictal period of 30 minutes to 2 hours. Here is a boy, young boy, presented with generalized tonic-clonic seizures. His head turns to the left side, associated with tonic-clonic movements of all 4 limbs. In this video, only right upper limb is seen. Actually, this is the clonic stage of the seizures. Now there is some frothy discharge from his mouth, from his subset of his mouth. So the seizure is nearly it's going to end now. Next type of seizure is the simple partial seizure. The main difference between the simple partial seizure and the generalized tonic-clonic seizure is consciousness is not altered in simple partial seizures, and patient may have an aura, and the seizure may be a motor or sensory seizure. If it's a motor seizure, depends upon the lobe of involvement, the manifestation is there in the face, neck, or in the extremity. And the patient may feel sometimes feeling funny or something crawling inside me, and there is no postictal phenomena. Uh-huh. Here is a young girl presented with simple partial seizure. See, when you look carefully, her left side of cheek and the upper lip, minimal twitching movement is there. This is a simple partial motor seizure. Then complex partial seizure. The complex partial seizure, always the consciousness is impaired and patient may present it with aura. There is a brief blank stare or sudden cessation or pause in activity, and automatisms will be there. Automatisms are complex motor activity. At that time the patient was in, the sensorium was altered and followed by an amnestic phase. The patient is not able to recognize what had happened at that time. And the automatisms may be some lip smacking movement, chewing, swallowing or excessive salivation, and the duration is usually 1 to 2 minutes and it usually occurs during the waking hours. This is a video of complex partial seizures. This is the automatisms. See, it's the hand automatisms. Now she is picking up the cloth of the other person. She is confused. She is walking here and there. This is the complex partial seizures. Then next seizure type is the absence seizure. The usually it's very frequent, it's as many as 100 times per day or more. The classical semiology is brief staring spells, often with fluttering of eyelids, lasting only a very few seconds. Typically it's up to 15 seconds at a time. And there is a sudden cessation of motor activity or speech at third time, and there is no aura or no postictal state. And hyperventilation aggravate the absence seizure. EEG showed classical 3 per second spike and wave activity. She is a young school going girl presented with absence seizure. Now she starts hyperventilating. She is conscious now. Now see her eye movements and the lip movements. It lasts for very few seconds. At that time she was unaware. Now she is once again conscious. So how we will differentiate between the complex partial seizure and absence seizures? Few points. Usually the answer in complex partial seizure, it may have a simple partial onset, and absence seizures has got abrupt onset. And the duration is more than 30 seconds in complex partial and it's less than 30 seconds in absence seizure. Automatisms are usually common with complex partial seizure and it is duration dependent in absence seizures. Even in absence seizure also sometimes automatisms will be there. There is atypical absence. Then awareness is usually lost in both complex partial and the absence seizures, and ending is gradual postictal in complex partial and abrupt end in absence seizures. Then next seizure type is the myoclonic seizure. In myoclonic seizure, quick muscle jerk is there and the body tone is usually lost. Consciousness is usually retained and it present in specific epileptic syndromes. Example like Lennox-Gastaut syndrome or inverted lumbar disease. This is the typical myoclonic jerk. See. Next thing is the seizure mimics, or what are the differential diagnoses for seizures. First condition is the breathhold interval, then syncopal attack, third one is the migraine, then tics, night terrors and pseudo seizures. We have to differentiate from all these conditions. Few points about the breathhold interval. It is frightening to the parents. Usual age group is between 6 months to 4 years, and the positive family history will be there in 20 to 30% of patients. And the event is, it's an inciting event with shrill cry, breath holding in expression, and followed by cyanosis. It disappears spontaneously before school age. Now the child is crying. At the end of the cry, the child fell down and the child was unconscious briefly. This is the typical video of the breath holding spell. Pseudo seizures. Everybody in our office practice, you will see the pseudo seizures, particularly in young females between 10 to 18 years, and it's a diagnosis of exclusion. The postures will be very bizarre, and the patient may talk at the time of seizures. Verbalization will be there, uncharacteristic movements, and there's no cyanosis, and it's normal reaction to people, and no loss of sphincter control, and there's no postictal drowsiness. It can be pursued and have an attack on the request, and there's no response to AED. This is an example for pseudo seizures. See the bizarre movement, it doesn't fit with any characteristic or type of semiology of the seizures. She is moving her both upper limb and minimally lower limb. Now it stopped. That's a minimal dose of ether was given through the nose. That's it. So now few points about the status epilepticus. Status epilepticus is defined as 5 minutes or more of continuous clinical and or electrographic seizure activity or recurrent seizure activity without recovery returning to baseline during the seizures. In our older terminology and older books, the duration was mentioned as 30 minutes. Now the recent recommendation is if a patient presented with 5 minutes or more of seizures, take it as status epilepticus. For our practical purposes, when a patient or child presented to the casualty with seizures, take it as status epilepticus. This is the classification of status epilepticus based on the etiology. It is cryptogenic, remote symptomatic, febrile, acute symptomatic, and progressive encephalopathy. And classification of status epilepticus, once again, is convulsive and non-convulsive. Under the heading of convulsive, it is generalized, focal, and others. Under the non-convulsive, it is absent seizures and focal. Initial home treatment for status epilepticus. Is it possible that home treatment for status epilepticus? Rectal diazepam in a dose of 0.5 mg per kg and intranasal midazolam in a dose of 0.2 mg per kg may be tried in status epilepticus. The general principles for status epilepticus is treat early and aggressively. The early treatment gives better results and identification of etiological and aggravating factors. Then there should be a clear return plan in the hospital and always call the neurologist immediately for status epilepticus. This is the ABCD. As for the any other emergency, ABCD for status epilepticus. A stands for airway, B for breathing circulation, D stands for dextrostin. Brief history. In a child presented to the casualty with status epilepticus, first we have to ask whether the child is a known seizure patient or not a known seizure patient. If patient is a known seizure patient, check for missed medications. Missed medications are the commonest cause for status epilepticus. Then if child is not a known epileptic, ask history about the birth and family history and is there any provoking factors like any fever, headache, vomiting or head injury. For pediatric practice, always ask for neem oil injection. Most of the time for URI they will give neem oil with camphor. Camphor is an irritant which causes the status epilepticus. Then rapid neurological evaluation. Doing observation and GCS score, cranial nerves, in the cranial nerves, look carefully for fundus examination and motor and sensory system. Then assessment, babesiosis in a child with status epilepticus, took CBC, serum electrolytes, calcium, glucose, phosphorus and magnesium and anticonvulsant levels if applicable and do lumbar puncture only when you are suspecting meningitis and consider toxicology screening and metabolic and genetic testing only specific concerns at first seizures. Then consider neuroimaging, CT scan or MRI, obtain an EEG. Initial management, first establish an IV access, dextrose 25% in a dose of 2 to 4 ml per kg, then pyridoxin 70 mg per kg in selected cases, then use anticonvulsants. Then initial route, if we are able to establish the IV route, yes, continue with IV route. If most of the time in pediatrics, that's IV route is, it's IV line not secure, so at third time we can use the pararectal diazepam or buccal midazolam we can try, or intranasal midazolam or intramuscular lorazepam we can try, or intraosseous route we can try with intraosseous route. We can introduce the bone marrow needle into the tibia, then through that we can connect the IV line. Then this is the initial treatment without IV recommendations. Then the midazolam in a dose of for IM midazolam it is 0.2 mg per kg, buccal midazolam 0.5 mg per kg, nasal is 0.2, lorazepam buccal is 0.1 mg per kg, diazepam rectum 0.2 to 0.5 mg per kg. Then this chart should be there in all the hospitals, those who are level 3 or level 4 care. Initial 0 to 5 minutes ABCD history neurological evaluation, then at the first 5 to 10 minutes start with lorazepam in a dose of 0.05 to 0.1 mg per kg associated with phenytoin or phosphenytoin in a dose of 20 mg per kg. Then if it's not settled at the time of 30 to 40 minutes, once again off the dose of phenytoin or phosphenytoin, that's 10 mg per kg. At third time if it's not settled, we can consider third line drugs. In the third line drugs we can consider sodium valproate or levetiracetam. Then 30 to 60 minutes phenobarbital 20 mg per kg. At the end of 50 minutes, if the child is not responding, intubate and do the EEG monitoring. After 50 to 60 minutes, use anesthetic agents, midazolam in a dose of loading dose of 0.2 mg per kg followed by an infusion, pentobarbital in a loading dose of 5 mg per kg followed by infusion, propofol loading dose of 1 to 2 mg per kg followed by infusion. For remembering purpose, this is for midazolam 0.2 mg per kg loading followed by 0.2 mg per kg as an infusion, pento makes 5, so loading 5 mg followed by maintenance 5 mg, propofol 2 mg loading followed by maintenance 2, so 0.2 to 5. This is the minimum, this is the for remember purpose. Then for 3 to 24 hours, correct the underlying cause and adjust the AUD dose. At the end of 24 to 48 hours only, we can try to taper the anesthetic agents. If hyponatremia is documented, give 5 cc per kg of 3% saline. If hypocalcemia is there, 20 mg per kg of calcium chloride. Few words, now 3-4 slides are there. One is refractory status epilepticus. So definition wise, refractory status epilepticus is continued seizure after 2 or 3 anti-epileptic drugs have failed. We will usually need EEG monitoring at this point, typically titrate to bus suppression pattern. So what are the drugs tried in the refractory status epilepticus? We can use inhalation anesthetics, pentobarbital, propofol infusion, midazolam, valproic acid, levetiracetam and consider IV pyridoxine. Non-convulsive status epilepticus, if a child does not begin to respond to painful stimuli within 20 to 30 minutes after a seizure, suspect non-convulsive status epilepticus, do an urgent EEG. Up to 20% of children with status epilepticus have a non-convulsive status epilepticus after a tonic-clonic status epilepticus. So finally, the take-home points for this lecture. Better outcome if your status epilepticus stopped earlier, and use the treatment algorithm. If you are going through the treatment algorithm, we are always in the right path. And lorazepam is the best first-line anticonvulsant. And phosphenytoin surpasses the phenytoin for status epilepticus now. And consider anesthetic agents for refractory status epilepticus. Non-IV routes to be considered in pediatric patients. Thank you.